There are a lot of challenges when flying airplanes. Low visibility, icing, big thunderstorms. Today, it's going to be wind. Welcome aboard, guys. Today we are back in the Bahamas. We're at San Andros here on Andros Island. We're going to do a VFR flight to Stanial Cay. I'm going to start up the caravan here. We just landed. So we're going to motor down to 150 on the ITT. As soon as the ITT gets to 150, introduce the fuel to low idle. Now that's when we go to watching the ITT rise up for hot starts. We're watching. And we're also watching for hung starts with the NG.
System terrain test system okay. Test okay.
All right, all systems check. We're good to go. We're at San Andros here, and this is an uncontrolled airfield. So we'll make an announcement before we taxi out onto the runway. Actually, there's a plane coming in right now. We'll wait for him. Air call.
I'll clear the altitude 1,000.
Roger, thanks. San Andros, any other traffic inbound San Andros?
I didn't hear anything.
Roger, thanks. Have a good day.
All right, bro.
San Andros, you have a caravan. We're back tracking. We're only 1-2, San Andros. All right.
Up to you. You got an Navajo 5.
We'll turn on all the lights now that we're going to be entering the runway. All right. Clear to the left. And clear to the right. On this flight, we're going to be going direct to Stanial Cay, 103 miles. We're going to go up to 7,500 feet for our cruise altitude. There's not a lot on Andros Island. I know it is big for bone fishing on the shores and the coastlines here. We're getting to the end of the runway here. We'll do a U-turn and we'll make our call, letting everybody know we're leaving. San Andros, you have a caravan. We're going to be taking off for runway 12, departing to the southeast, San Andros. All right, we'll line up here. Our winds are coming out of the, a little bit off the left of the runway here this morning. We'll ease the prop RPM up. And now we'll advance the torque for takeoff power. And it is set. Little temperatures, pressures all look good in the green. I'm pushing a lot with my right leg right now on the right rudder. With these caravans, they have a lot of tendency to want to pull left because of the prop spinning. A lot of torque. Have to watch out for birds here. There's usually a lot of birds that fly around this area. All right, we'll bring our first notch of flaps up. It's windy up here. It's these caravans. There's a lot of manipulation with the yoke when they fly these things. Alright, we'll bring our flaps up here. And even though we select it, we always make sure it's indicating also. And it is. We are extremely light today, guys. It's just me and you on board, so this thing's climbing pretty good right now. And so I don't have to keep applying pressure in the climb with my right leg on the rudder. What I'm doing down here is I'm turning the rudder trim so that way I can basically take my feet right off the rudders now, and it's trimmed out where it's holding coordinated flight in the climb. And as you climb with the turboprops, your torque will drop. But we can continue to add power in until you're limited with the ITT.
Any traffic landing, Stanial.
There, we got somebody else going in the Stanial.
Stanial traffic, get a light turn. We're going to enter the left downwind. Land 3-4, Stanial.
All right, sounds like he's going to be using runway 3-4. Since there's no weather reporting out here, being able to listen to what the other pilots are using before you get there is a really handy tool. All right, we've had some fun hand flying it here. We'll put the autopilot on. We're going to go into heading mode and VS at 800 feet a minute. Since we're pretty light, we'll climb at 800 feet a minute up to 7,500.
Marsh Harbor traffic, Falcon 118.
With the caravan, I like to climb out around 110 knots. That seems to be a nice speed that I like to utilize for climbing in the caravan. With the TBM, I like to climb out at 130 or 140, depending on my mood. Usually it's a good mood, so. All right, now that we're clear of these clouds, we'll go direct, enter, to Stanial Cay. It's the 128 heading, so we'll turn 9 degrees to the left here. We're coming off the east coast of San Andros here. The water actually gets very deep in this area. You'll see there's a Navy base right down that way. And the submarines will do a lot of training out here. It's pretty cool when you can see either some of the Navy ships or the submarines when they're doing drills on top of the water with the submarines. You can see them out there every once in a while. All right, we're leveling out here at 7,500, a cruise altitude. What we're going to do is let the airplane build up its speed, build up some momentum here, and then we'll set our cruise power. All right, we let the airplane build up some speed here. We're doing 150 knots. What we're going to do now is set our cruise power. We've got our prop RPM here. We're going to pull that back. Our ITT is right where we want it, 700. And our torque is not going to over-torque as we pull it back. That's a good spot. So we're going to come down here with the blue lever. I'm going to pull this back. And there goes our prop RPM. We'll drop and the torque will rise a little bit. What we're looking for is 1750 on the prop RPM. There we go. Prop RPM's looking good. Torque's looking good. Got your oil pressure, we'll check all that. Temperatures, looking good. Just that cruise power. So yeah, when it comes to flying airplanes, you know, there's a lot of different challenges. I mean, shooting approaches down minimums, deviating around big thunderstorms. There's a lot of different things that, on every flight that, you know, presents challenges to you. Today, we're gonna be dealing with crosswind landings. And if we go down here and we scroll over to the weather page, and we go zoom in and look up here at Stanial Cay, you're gonna see there's our airport, and you have all our little wind indicators showing at the surface. We've got 20 knots coming off the right side today, which we're gonna come in for 3-4. Looks like it's barely favoring 3-4. So that's what we're gonna be taking on today, is a 20 knot direct crosswind from the right, with a little bit favoring to runway 3-4. The challenge in particular with this runway is there's a hill right on that side of the airport in the island where the wind will come over and it swirls down onto the runway area. So it'll be a smooth ride right up until about short final, and then that's when you're really going to get the bumps and have to adjust for all the wind swirling around. I have a feeling my friend Speedbird might be out in front of us here this morning. Let's see if we can get a hold of him. Speedbird, you on the frequency?
Hey Steve, how you doing?
Hey Speedbird, how are you doing? I'm doing good. Ready for some crosswind landings today?
Oh yeah, I'm about 14 miles out of Stanial and just thinking about that.
Well that's good. I'm glad you're out in front of me because I'm hoping you can give me a little report of what the conditions are like on short final and into the flare there.
Yeah, well, we'll do. And as you know, Steve, there's no weather reporting facility down here.
Hey, exactly. It's nice to have other friends and pilots that you know out here that you know will give a reliable report.
I can tell now just by looking at the ocean, you've got the white caps and that. That gives me a sign that it's 15 knots and plus. So we're probably looking around about 15 to 20 knots today on a crosswind going into Stanial.
All right, well, it was nice talking with you, Speedbird. We'll talk to you again here soon for the briefing, but appreciate you talking with us.
Roger. Thanks, Steven.
We're about 18 minutes out.
How am I doing, Bob?
Our fuel tanks are nice and even. We'll start our descent. We'll go down to 1,500 feet. We'll VS about 500 feet a minute, which is nice.
Steve, I just landed 3-4 in Stanial.
How was the approach, Speedbird?
This is Skyhawk, just departed Norman's, en route to Nassau 20.
Well, Speedbird tried to give us a report, but due to our distance away from each other, we won't be able to hear him. If you actually look at the Bahamas and Caribbean pilot guide, and you go to Stanial Cay, look what it actually says. We got caution, often strong crosswinds. So yeah, they even warn you about it when you come into this airport. When you fly into Stanial Cay, you get good at your crosswind landings. All right, we got the Exuma chain coming up here, guys. Where the Exumas really gets beautiful is when it's low tide.
Okay, thanks.
It actually looks like it's high tide right now. Yeah, when it's low tide, all the sandbars will pop out. It's really nice. Right now, our onboard computer is saying the wind's at 065 at 30. It should be less when you get down towards the ground compared to being up here. Got Johnny Depp's Island right out here in front of us. Stanial Cay Caravan, we're 12 miles to the northwest, descending out of 1,500 bound Stanial. Alright guys, it's time to get ready to go to work. The view in the Bahamas never gets old. It's beautiful down here. I love the Exumas. Right in front of us here, this is Compass Cay.
Bahamas traffic, you have a twin at 6,000 feet inbound to Stanial descending.
Compass Cay is where you can swim at the nurse sharks in the marina right there. If you ever go to Compass Cay here, be sure to say hi to my friend Tucker. Real nice guy. Right down there, I don't know if you guys can see
it. Stanial traffic, twin Cessna 6867 Zulu, back taxiing north runway Stanial Cay.
Looks like quite a few yachts there this morning.
Advise.
Right over to the left right here, this is where that sandbar is, that everybody has the sandbar parties, which is really fun. What's really nice when you stay at the Stanial Cay Yacht Club is you get a little skiff and you can go explore all these little islands all on your own, whichever little beach you like. You know, you go up on there and you have a little party on the, for the day on the beach. There's over yonder key right here. The windmills are spinning. Stanial Cay, caravan 5 miles to the northwest, going to be entering left downwind for 3-4, Stanial Cay. Actually, guys, the next beach coming up is the island where all the pigs live and swim around the ocean. There's actually another YouTube channel that I follow, it's called Gone with the Winds. They used to be an RV show, or RV channel, now they sail a catamaran around, and they're actually anchored in this little bay here today, so maybe we'll see them. There's a lot of boats, so I don't know which catamaran they would be. Anyway, if Gone with the Winds, if you see yourself down there, let us know which one you are. Yeah, right down there is where they're all anchored up, right by where the pigs swim around. Alright, there's the yacht club right there off our left. We're making an announcement here. Stanial Cay Caravan, midfield left downwind for 3-4, Stanial Cay. Alright, we're going to pull the
traffic,
power back here.
Twin, that's 25 out, inbound Stanial.
Put some flaps in here. Right, this is going to be a challenge, guys. We are extremely light. And it's on 25 knots. With these type of landings, you're not
and
looking
the wind, you're favoring 3-4, Stanial.
For greasers, you're just looking to get it down safely. Stanial Cay Caravan, turning mile and a half left base for 3-4, Stanial Cay. Yeah, the winds are kicking, guys. I mean, it is. Those waves are pretty big over there. 500 feet to the ground. I'm basically just going to let the airplane hold the crab all the way to the runway, and then right in the flare is where I'm going to kick in the rudder and straighten it out and try to get it down safely. You got to always remember, go-arounds are always an option if you don't like the way things are feeling. Stanial Cay Caravan turning a 1 mile final for 3-4, Stanial.
Stanial traffic, give a twin 20 northwest at 4,000 descending.
Alright.
We're trying to get a report
this
on the runway.
Crab angle is ridiculous, guys. We're flying completely
sounds
sideways.
Like everybody's using 3-4, my friend. Yeah, okay. Got a twin session to party, Stanial Cay. Turn heading 283 and we're out.
Quite the crab angle, guys.
5 out of 2,000.
Gonna let it hold it. I'm gonna kick the rudderman. Oh, we got a gust. There we go. And I'm holding an extreme crosswind correction here. Yeah, that windsock is straight out. We actually touched down really smooth, but it was sketchy. That's it was showing about 25 knots. I'm glad to be on the ground, guys. How about you? I'll tell you, these Bahamian pilots, too, they have nerves of steel. You know, that's an adrenaline rush for me. Those guys, doesn't even faze them. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. Be sure to smash the thumbs up button and subscribe, ring the little bell to get notified when I upload videos. Hope you guys are all doing good. Where should we park? So we go right over here to the right. Yeah, you can see the trees out there. They're just cranking in this wind. Here, I'll let you guys see. Look at this windsock. Here, look at that. Straight across the runway, gusting pretty good. Anyway, guys, hope you guys are all doing good. And we'll talk to you again someday soon. Take care. To